First, I would like to thank Dr. Dinesh for giving me this opportunity to share some of my understanding about grassroots innovations. Our earlier speakers have spoken about importance of grassroots innovations and its scope for sustainability, distributions, distributive justice, etc. I have taken a different approach to understand grassroots innovations, particularly in context of India, developing countries. So my theme of understanding grassroots innovation is from sociological perspective. How I will proceed is the first, importance of grassroots innovations have been already established and have been advocated by peoples and policymakers. And there are lots of mapping and documentation exercises are going on, the necessity of which could not be questioned. And then the people have also talked about the types of grassroots innovations, like institutional and technicals. Or just previous speakers have highlighted that we have talked about technical innovations and not the social and institutional innovations, which are essential for development and our growth. But it is not so. There are many other speakers in the first day itself spoken about that how in Gujarat grassroots peoples form the community tubal companies, or in the Punjab the people form the second-hand market, tractor market, and like many other local institutions have been evolved. So I will not be talking about institutional or social innovations. I will be focusing on technical innovations only. And one technical innovations I will be taking, talking about the social construction of grassroots technology. That how a particular grassroots technology is socially constructed. We have to see that how this grassroots technology has come into existence. And a case study I will be referring about the irrigation technology in India, how this irrigation technology has evolved, and how irrigation technology have been adopted, modified at the grassroots level, and what happened when all this mapping, documentation, networking, and new kind of commercialization takes place and diffusion takes place to, on large scales to these grassroots innovations. However, a little bit I would also like to talk about this entire debate of grassroots innovations. As we know that grassroots innovations is highlighted in terms of development. We know that development is the requirement of our present and sustainability is the concern of, for the futures. But the questions that we need to address is, do we require any new technical innovations for development? I don't think we require any new technical innovations for development. Whatever criteria of development we decide today, we have the existing technology to provide that things. If we want to provide education, health, road, infrastructure, anything, all kinds of technology are available. But only question is sustainability. Do we want that all our 1 billion people should own Mercedes? Is it possible? Technology is available. But is it also feasible or sustainable? Probably not. That's why we require grassroots innovations. But the questions come the equality. What kind of policy or what kind of developments or sustainability we are expecting? What kind of policy we are making? For one group of peoples, high modern technology, another group of peoples, grassroots innovations are lower kind of technology we are expecting. Second things we have also to think about relations between grassroots innovations and large-scale industrial innovations. Where they are fitting, what are the relationships, how we are going to adjust with them. Next thing is the grassroots innovation for whom and why. And mapping, documenting, networking, institutionalization of grassroots innovations. Do we see any kind of politics behind this grassroots innovations so that a large section of people get a little bit, so that minor sections of people can enjoy the better technology, better things in the life. However, this, there are the many things that could be discussed, but my themes of presentation is social construction of grassroots technology. One grassroots technology that I will be talking about, the irrigations. So let us discuss about this thing. As we know that innovative peoples are found in all societies, but their innovative capacity vary from society to society. Social structure, cultural values, and challenges from nature or from other society are individual, what Tainubi said, and the response of society determines the variations in the quality or quantity of innovations. Like all other innovations, grassroots innovations are the result of combining existing and known elements of culture. They are cumulative in nature. Just like modern advanced technology like floating log to modern diesel engine motor boat, the present diesel motor boat is a cumulative evolution of floating logs. It started from there, then boat, then we put the motor, and then motor, steam motor boat came into existence. Some sociologists have documented and analyzed how different kind of technology have came into existence. However, this accumulation process is not spontaneous. It requires certain kind of triggerings. And these triggerings, like just any other kind of innovations, is also applicable to grassroots innovations. So grassroots innovations also occur through four stages. First is the perception of the problem. When some problems are not solved or unsatisfactorily solved, then a problem is perceived. So that is the first stage, when people perceive there is a problem. Then there is a second stage called setting the stage of collecting all the information, all the data, all the available techniques. They try to assemble it. And then act of insight also occurred, that how to put, how to use different kind of data, different kind of information to solve that particular problems. However, while devising solutions, there's a kind of critical revision. They experiment with different techniques, different combinations and permutations. And here goes the critical revisions. And many times, cultural, social, and economic factors come in development of any kind of grassroots innovations or modern innovations. Second things that we generally find, and Professor Anil Gupta also referred many of his talk, that we have the similar solution for similar problem across the country. Many countries simultaneously they evolve similar solution for similar problem. So what are the reasons? One reason that is generally given is the unity of human psyche that social anthropologists have documented, that probably human beings have this kind of human psyche, that if same problem is there, they may develop the same solution. However, we also find different solutions for similar problem. And why it happened? Because of geographical, social, cultural, and economic diversity. In our case study, we will find that how for a particular problems, people have evolved different solutions. And because of this geographical, social, and cultural factors. However, when we talk about construction of technology, construction of grassroots technology, we find that is not the one final product that comes at a point. Rather, there are different variant of solution to a problem are floated, and selection or choice is made as per the availability of social and material culture. Over a period of time, one particular variant gets stabilized, but its diffusion becomes restrictive because of many reverse silence. These are glitches, are technical glitches. I will also explain when I discuss the drip irrigations. So this framework I have used to understand the innovations for irrigation technology in India. Now you see, this is the one techniques that in India people use for lifting the water from the pond for irrigating their land. Here if you see, this is the small basket things and tied with the two ropes and two women are lifting the water. This is very common in northern India and eastern part of India. But here now you see this is the individual efforts for lifting water individually and sprinkling the water from the canal, not the canal, but it also kind of silo ponds running across the field. Now, this is a different way for lifting the water from the well. Where the water is, table is very deep, they have evolved this kind of technology. It is also found commonly in many parts of India. Now, this you see lifting water individually again here. This is somewhere, this picture was taken by it shown on the internet, but caption shows that picture was taken from a mobile camera. Someone was going from Howrah to Kharagpur in the West Bengal regions. Now you see also how they are lifting the water. Same technology could have been used that we saw in the first slide, that is Dogli that they use, but this is the Dhekuli, a different kind of technology they have used. Now, this is also another common site for lifting up the water. This is the Persian waste which was evolved in Middle East and came in India, many part of India, it is also used. But even there is a variation of this Persian use also. Now you see here, this is the man-made, the human use of human power for lifting the water. Water is not very deep, water is just 2 to 3, 2 meters, not more than 2 meters, and this person is using handmade tools for lifting the water. But here, they are using the animal power, and here is the bullock they are using, and with the same Persian wheels. Sorry. Now here, another animal, buffalo, they are using here, the same animal power they are using for lifting the water. Now here, camel, again, geographical variations is making differences in the technology that we are using. Now here, they have coupling the animal powers. Why it has not been coupled to other places, why they have coupled? It is because of the water tables, more if you say, want to bring more water or some things that we require in-depth study. Now, if we go to other regions, so they have a different kind of technology. Northeast, we find trapping spring water from bamboo drip. When water comes through the streams, they trap that water through the bamboo pipe and take it to their field in the form of drip irrigation. In many northeast part of the country, we find this technology is prevalent. But this is the luxury of water, this modern pumping set or tube wells, electric operated or diesel engine operated, where they use water like this. This is not only for irrigating, but also a fun washing car and also for bathing. However, grassroots innovations also sometimes involved in modification and alteration of modern technology. This is the things I wanted to show, that what happened when local grassroots innovations get commercialized, when these modern institutional systems are involved in spreading or diffusion of grassroots innovation technology. And this is the very, I think some of you must be familiar, Pepsi system of drip irrigation. This is the case study was carried out by this extensive study was carried out by Burma, Silpi Burma and others in 2004, and it was also published in Water Policy 2004. This was the modern system of irrigations that was introduced by one international development enterprises for promotion of organic cotton farming in West Nimar district of MPs during 1990s. These institutions and wanted that farmers should start organic farming, but the initial investment was $150 per acre, and they require this kind of investment, and it was very essential because that region was water scarce regions. However, many farmers were not able to spend this much of money for their field, so they were looking for some kind of alternatives. This international development enterprises tried for very hard to sell their technology, but it was not successful. After 6-7 years, they left this place and they started doing something else. But the farmers, they realized the importance of drip irrigations, so they kept on doing some kind of innovation, some kind of experiments. So what they did first, they used the cycle tubes, they used the bamboo pipes, they used the loose ropes for drip irrigation purposes. So just you see that before a final product comes, many different kind of experiments were performed, and some were also used on a small scale. What happened by 1998-99, a new innovation called Pepsi was tried. The Pepsi is basically, there was a very strong small candy manufacturer used light density plastic to fill ice candy, which are sold as Pepsi in the local market in some region of Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. These candies are 20 centimeter in length and transparent, and farmer get at the rate of $1.5 per kg. So these rolls come in a long plastic strips. So instead of cutting them, they started using this plastic roll is used in place of the drip tubes, and it's placed directly at the root zones of the plants. The entire system becomes locally assembled and very cost effective. And what happened in course of time, they also evolved a recycled version of Pepsi that was black in color, earlier was in the white in color and transparent. But this Pepsi was much cheaper. So they started using, so it became most cost effective. And when people started using on large scale, then IDA again realized the importance of this thing, and they came up their own version of Pepsi and started marketing for vegetables growers. So here the things happened. Now you see how these farmers are using this Pepsi tubes for irrigation purpose. And this is the also local women are also assembling this thing for their small fields. So what happened when this technology become very popular, the large number of plastic manufacturers in Indore and other part of local areas, they emerged, and they started manufacturing these Pepsi pipes. And wholesalers, retailers, agri-implement wholesalers, all they came into existence in nearby market, and they came to sell this thing. So what happened, this initial advantage of cost effectiveness was neutralized by the entry of market and farmer institution, as it had limited life period, high labor requirement, low pressure, deposition of algae, etc. In the beginning, it was very efficient because cost effective in comparison to microtip. But what happened, it has a very high replacement cost, unequal distribution of water, environmental problem with the polythenes. Huge quantity of polythenes also get deposited in the fields. In a survey, it was found that Pepsi adapter gets 7.5, 4 kg per acre yield, while microtube adapter gets 7.62 kg yield. There were there was not any advantage for this Pepsi. So initial cost was, if less, then their yield was not very substantive. And what happened in the course of time, the decreasing prices of microtubes also threatened this local grassroots innovations. So now they are on the way of their phasing out. And this microtips, because of many institutional support and decreasing cost of their technology, it is now becoming popular and farmers have started adapting. So now the question that comes, that when we talk about linking this grassroots innovations with the modern system of things, to what extent they would be sustainable in the long term for the farmer itself. Thank you very much. Yeah.